Yeah, okay, guys, thank you very much once again. This is Pro Graphics. The previous video I did about retouching using frequency separation, and I'm going to continue with this particular image from here. And this, we are going to do our dodge and bend. We are going to do our color grading and color correction and make sure that our subject pops out and every color looks brighter and catchy. Yeah, that's what I mean. So there's the frequency separation that we did on the face, so you can look at it before, after, before, after. Okay, so whilst we were doing it, we didn't do the next. So remember, you go back to your lower frequency. Then I continue from here. Okay, so go to blur, Gaussian blur. Remember, we used 18, 36 over here. It's not bad. Okay, so let's try with the 36. Let me try the face again with 36 and see how smooth the face will be. But actually, as I said in a previous video, I don't really like my images to look plastic. I want my images to always, okay, so I like it this way. So let's do something over here. Now we shouldn't forget about the hands. So let's do something about the hands. Okay. Okay. And always, you should make sure that you work with raw images. Work with, because they are heavy. They're heavy for you to retain all your details. We're doing the eye whitening. Yeah, so I think over here we can continue with our color grading or color correction. So you go to your camera raw. Okay, so now it has popped. Let's do some color correction. Okay. So mostly, which color over here do you want it to pop? Let's check the brown or the oranges, sorry. So we can make the oranges pop like this. Then let's look at the reds. Let's give it a little bit. Then let's come to the basics. Then let me add the blacks a little bit. Then let's give some small. Good. Okay, so I have to look at it, looks too colorful. But what we are going to do is we are going to mask so that we take the colors from the face, the hands, and but I think with the background and the table and everything is okay, so that we can give her a good skin color. Yeah, with this one it looks so. You duplicate it by pressing Ctrl J, then I mask it. I take my brush. I remember when your foreground within the masking is white, you use a black color as your brush. So let me zoom in. Then I begin to paint. So let me paint it out. There's something happening. Need to be attentive to see that. Good. So let me reduce the brush a little bit. Don't worry, the changes will happen. It's because my machine is somehow becoming slow. That's why you're not seeing any change. Sorry, I need to delete this one because it's duplicated. Sorry, I have to delete this one. So you can see. Okay. So, sorry, I have to click on this one. Then work on it very well. We are going to give another skin color, so don't worry about it. So let us clean all those colors. In fact, I love the skin color. So let's take this reddish out. In fact, in this image, we are going to do more of the masking. Yeah, very, very important. We are going to do more of the masking. Very, very important, so that we know how to choose the colors and make things work better. Okay, so don't forget to like and subscribe and share the page so that you'll be motivated to do more videos of this kind. Okay. Oh, okay. So I think we are done with our masking now. So I'll press on the shift and select all, control alt shift E. Then it will merge all. So now this is what I have. So let me group this again. Then before, after, before, after, before, after. Okay, so I control E again. Okay, good. Now let's come to the skin and let's work on the skin. Okay, so what I'll do is I'll go back to camera raw. That's what I used to do. Gives more of the highlights. Don't worry about that. Then I bring this down a little bit. Let's look at it before, after. Then my white should go down a little bit. My blacks, small of the contrast. Okay. So I just click OK. And I'm going to mask again. It looks nice, but let me mask again. Now change my mask by pressing on. Invert. I click it. I control I will invert it. Okay, so that's how we go about it. Then I begin to. Change your brush, don't forget. And I begin to paint. So what will happen over here is you realize that the face will begin to pop out because we have added a little of brightness to the face. Let's look at it. don't know if you can see it, but from over here, I can see it. Let's come to the hand. Let's do that to the hand too. Let's come to this one too. Let's do something about it. Okay. Now, as I'm done, I'll still do it again, merge it, duplicate it. Then let me choose, let's deal with the skin toning. I usually don't name my my work, so I invert it. I don't like skin color, yeah, I don't do that. But as you follow it, you can see what I double click, then I choose the skin color over here. Now remember, we are masking. So the brush over here, so I begin to paint where I think, if you want to see the face well, you can lower the opacity a little bit and begin to do your painting. So, lower brush a little bit. Now don't worry, you are going to work on it. It's not going to be like this. A lot of people do it this way and they become confused how to go about it, but there's nothing to be confused about over here. Okay, let's work. But I'll be dealing with some few actions, so you are free to ask questions within the comment section. This hand, let's continue by doing this one too. Now you should know that you can change the skin color at any time because you are masking, so you can do that. So let me choose this one. Let me try to change it. I see something like this. Oh, brown. Okay, then remember you change the blending mode to soft light. Now before, after, so you can choose. Oh, even you have even reduced the opacity, so you're not even, but if the opacity is there, this size is going to be. Sometimes you can increase the opacity to know places that you haven't applied. Don't worry about the eyes, we are going to do the eye whitening, so there's no need to worry about the eyes. All you need to know is we need to all you need to do is like, share and subscribe my page so that I can do more videos. Okay. So when you look at this side, something needs to be done. Actually, I don't want this video to keep long, but I also need to take my time so that you understand what we are doing over here. Okay, so you can see now the skin color skin color is uniform before, after, before, after. So let's reduce the opacity. Let's reduce the opacity to somewhere 37. Let's say before, after, before, after. Good. I think you are getting somewhere. So that is the skin. I would even name skin color. Okay, let's name skin color. Then let's group all again. Image. Then let's come to camera raw. My scratch disk is full. Sorry. Let me do some few things over here so I can get enough space. I'll be with you shortly. I think my space is full, so I need to clear some few things so that I can get enough space to continue with this work. Okay, let me come back and see if it will work. Camera raw. Yes, I'm back. Okay, so now from here we can see that the image is looking better than before. Now, what I do is I come and calibrate the colors. So, now what we do over here is you tune the image to how you feel is good. I'm still working on the skin though. So let's see. Before, after, before, after. It looks too reddish. Okay. Before, after. Before, after. Before, after. Okay. So let's do some okay over here. Then, still on the face, let me pull some highlights, sorry, let me use curves. Let me pull some highlights. Remember, whenever you pull highlights, you should make sure that you contrast it, because what happens is that when there's more highlights, the mid tones and the dark tones, the mid tones, the dark tones and the highlights, they are all affected. So you need to do something about it so that there will be a difference between the mid tone, the dark tones and the highlights. Photo retouching is not all that easy. That's why you need to take a lot of money to charge, you need to charge you all so that you can do a quality job. Okay. I should know that this image, we are not done with it. That's in my language, so you can see. Now, why did we do this? We are doing it so that when you look at the image, your focus will not be on the background, but the first appearance should tell you that this image, your subject, it makes you focus on your subject. That's what I mean. Okay. So you can see that we use the same, adjust the curves to do the contrast. So you bring it down a little bit, then you send it up. Okay, so let's group this one and see before, after, before, after, before, after. Good. So As I do this, let's go back. Let's do some dodge and bend. I think our image is looking good. Yeah, our image is looking good now, but there are more to be done. That is retouching for you. Okay, so let's see. Sorry. Let's do some dodge and bend. So I have some actions over here that I usually use for the dodge and bend. So dodge, then bend. What I do basically, I group this and I name it dodge, or let's shorten it DMB. Sorry, dodge and bend. Okay, then I add the black and white to it. Why do I add the black and white? So that I can see, I put the red so that I can see the difference between the highlights, the shadows, and the dark tones. So that will help us. Now, you bend where the dark places, and you dodge where there is light, like the light places. Yeah. Forgive me. I'm trying to do some few things at the same time. Okay, so I'll pick my dodge. What I do is I bring down my opacity basically somewhere to 5. Okay. Then my brush. Remember, we are doing our dodge first. So I'll be dodging. So where I see light, I'll be dodging. And remember, because your opacity is at 5, whilst you are dodging, you wouldn't be there. You didn't see that. You wouldn't see the effect. Sorry, you didn't see the effect. Forgive me. Okay. So, now let's look at something. You can see. You can see. Now, for us not to forget some of the places, sometimes you need to do it bit by bit. So let's go back to the bending, then let's begin to bend the dark place. Please don't stress. Some people stress on it too much, so it becomes obvious. They misuse the dodge and bend. They misuse the dodge and bend. Okay, so let's come to there. So we dodge a little bit. So let's look at something. Let's see the hands. Most of the times, dealing with images like this, sometimes I want the image sometimes to look a little bit soft. Yeah. So. Okay, so let's look at before, after. I don't know if you can see it over here. Before, after, before, after, before. After, yes. Okay. So, now the black. Sometimes when I do this, I just add some of the black so that we add some small melanin skin. Something, but I'll dodge the black so that if the focus will be more on the face. Okay, let me increase the opacity to 100 so that it can be easier for us. Oh, sorry, white on white. Now, before you continue to motivate us, let's look at what you have done so far. Let's look at what you have done so far. So, before, after, before, after, before, after. Good. We are not done yet. Before we come to the eye whitening, sometimes I add what we call photo filter. Then I begin to manipulate it to check the one that might suit my work. If I don't get any of them, I just skip and continue. Okay, so I think we are not getting anything from here. So let me delete this, then go back to my eye whitening. I have some actions over here, but I have various way of whitening the eyes. So let me teach you the one that I use in Camera Raw. Today I want to limit the using of the actions. Okay, so we are not doing teeth whitening. So now I've set my texture to 71. My exposure, my contrast, and see over here I've reduced all the saturation because you don't need any color within. So let me take my brush. Okay, so let me begin to paint. So you begin to see there's something really happening over here. Okay. You need to do it so that it will look realistic. You shouldn't overdo it so that it will look like, sorry. Okay, so I think before, after, before, after, before, after. Okay. So we can see some changes. Good. Good, 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 good. Now, let me duplicate this. Go back to Camera Raw. And let me tweak the skin small. See, it's looking nice. So let's do something over here. Let's see. So reduce the reds a little bit. Yeah, I think this one will help. Yeah. So that will be for the face only. So remember, you are going to mask. So let's mask, invert the mask, and now begin to paint the face so that the colors will be popping. Be popping, very important. Don't worry about the lips and everything, you are going to do that. Still, I want us to retain the color. I want the skin color to look normal. Okay. So what I do from here is I take my hue and saturation, then I increase my hue and saturation a little bit. Okay, so before, after, before, after. So I use that for, I invert it and use that for the lips and the eyebrow. when you are dealing with color, sometimes some of the screens they look colorful. Yes, so and some of them too. The type of screen also determines. Okay. So let's look at the before and the after. Before, after, before, after, before, after. I think this image is looking good. If you think it's too much, you just reduce the opacity small so that it looks relatively okay. Okay. So most of the times, so let me add some actions to it to make it so simple. Let me try to add. I have a lot. Please, if you want the actions, you can message me in the comment section with your email. I'll forward the actions to you for free. Yeah. Okay. So, this one. Let's see if we can make the face a little bit smoother. But when you see that you are working on it and it looks some, you are done. You are done. Are done, but if you think it doesn't look okay, you gotta stop, you know. Yeah, so let me see if it's changing something. Oh, okay, so I think it's affecting my dodge and bend, so let me delete that. Okay, guys, so that will be the end of this video. Please don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you very much for paying. So let's look at it before, after, before, after. So you can see how the colors have popped out. Thank you, guys. Like and subscribe my page. Don't forget, it's ProGraphics. Thank you.